All right, Friday night, September 4th, 2020. The COVID elk hunting trip. It'll sneak away again for another week. Heading to a new spot, secret spot. Up by where Kyle lives, I'm meeting him tonight. He's probably up there. Probably meet up with him right at dark and walk in, pack in the dark, couple miles to a spot we've picked out on a map to base camp out of, so. It's gonna be a fun one. Liana's excited. Gotta wash my windshield, that'd be a good view of the Blue Mesa. Pretty good weather forecast, supposed to be fairly warm this weekend. For highs, lows aren't bad. But Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday next week, I think the high Tuesday, Ridgeway, is only, it's upper 50s. Chance of precipitation, low is 32, I believe. Had some big forest fires a couple weeks ago, mid-August, pop-up Pine Gulch fire, I think was the, last I looked, it was the second largest wildfire in Colorado history. I think it, 138,000 acres burned. And I don't know what the largest was. It might have overtaken that since I last checked, but they've really got that under control now. But smoke was a big concern for this trip a couple of weeks ago, and I think you can still see just a little bit of haze, just a little residual, but it's no longer a real concern, I don't think. But really, the goal is the fifth year down here. New first time at this spot, but fifth year to Colorado to elk hunt. And I really need to come home with some meat. That opportunity's the last 2 years just did not come together like they should have. So, I remain optimistic. Should be at the, up to the camp within an hour. Off the highway, it won't be long now. Heading up over those mountains. It's a pretty good view, I would say. Stay on the road. Better stay on the road. Boy, the road's a lot better up here. I want to get out and at least get walking in a little bit while I have some daylight. There's a stretch of timber, quarter mile stretch of timber that we have to walk through. Like to get through that with a little bit of light. And then the next mile and a half, we're gonna be walking through a meadow. There's some people. So I'm doing a little video. So we just got in. Well, probably 9:30, 10 o'clock, and probably 10 by now that we got the teepee set up. Going through looking for a little late night snack. We're gonna go hang our bear bag after we eat that and probably mosey on out to the meadow. There's a full moon out tonight. Probably just be real quiet. Eat our snack out there and listen for elk. Unwind a little bit. Hopefully there's some bugling bulls overnight or in the morning. We should pick up and get going and get out of where we're at. You probably can't see this, but up way over there where the sunlight is hitting the edge of that far meadow, there's a 20-30 elk herd moving in, so we're gonna get moving. Got done filling some water here on the way to cut off that herd. Kyle got impatient, he's moving already. He's up there, but I'll catch him quick, he's slow. Those elk were way behind those trees, moving from right to left. Actually, where we thought they were going to be coming, the wind wasn't great, so we came over to the other side. But we get on the other side of these trees, we should at least have a view of them if we can't get a play.
Well, we never ended up seeing those elk again. We kind of think we know what they did, but we're not sure. We're gonna go try to prove that out this morning, but now we're heading back to camp. I forgot my bugle tube. And gonna have some breakfast, I think. Didn't have the best tree for a bear bag, so we made a, it's more of a bear trap. We figured a bear could climb up that old dead tree, but if it does, the tree will fall down and scare it away. Or at least alert us that there's a bear in our stuff. Tomorrow we'll do a better bear bag. Like I said, we didn't run into those elk. So we wanted to come back to the point we saw them to confirm where we last saw them. So we came back over here after eating some breakfast. And while we're sitting here trying to, we confirmed we saw them way at the very edge there, going that way. So we marked that on the map. We're gonna walk straight to where we last saw them, try to see if we can follow a sign up and see where we think they cut up to bed. Kyle's going down to fill water, but just a second ago, I should have turned the camera on. I first thought I heard a bugle back up on that ridge with those dead trees. Something high-pitched, ears perked up, got excited. Then another one started, so I was thinking we had something to go chase, but right then it was a whole pack of coyotes. Just went nuts. And what time is it? It's late. It's almost 10 o'clock. I don't know if they took down an elk calf or made a little kill, but they were going nuts just 5 minutes ago. It's about 1:30 in the afternoon. Hadn't seen anything since this morning. Kyle was walking in front of me just now, and about 55, 60 yards, I saw a broadside elk on the trail. I couldn't get his attention in time. He took another step or two, and it kind of trotted off. It didn't spook real hard, but enough. And we walked into this, looks like a pretty good afternoon bed spot. So we're just gonna sit down here and take a nap, but Kyle doesn't like the location I chose. I put my bow right in bear crap. And more bear crap. And a lot of bear crap. I'd shoot that one, I think. So we're probably gonna take a nap right here. I don't think he's legal. First, all I could see straight on, so I could just see a beam.
Was he sleeping or standing?
He was standing up. God, do we follow him? They didn't spook too hard. It was one of those deals where I could just see, like from the side, I could see his shoulder to about right here, so I had a gap, you know, right of the vitals. And then around the tree, he was looking at me, all I could see is this rack straight on. And when he turned it to the side, I could just see the top fork. But usually when you get a top fork, like, you know, at the very end of the meme, another fork, I mean, I couldn't see his fronts or any of that. But I think I'm pretty sure I would have killed that elk if I wanted to.
You should have shot it.
My luck, we'd have got up there and he'd have been a 3-3. All right, Saturday night. Got into a little action in the bedding area this afternoon. We just bumped them. They weren't calling, but I had a 55-yard shot. Broadsided an elk. I just couldn't. I knew he was a bull, but I couldn't count his tines to see if he was legal until he left. Ended up he was, so should have shot that one. Then we bumped him. He was with one cow. Bumped him a couple of times. So now we moved camp, so we didn't have to sleep in that damp ground. We're sitting up on this little finger leading into the meadow. We'll see what happens. Water source is a little bit too cloudy, I guess, for my filter. I clogged up my filter last night or yesterday, so
it's delicious.
We're down to Kyle's filter and then the SteriPen, hoping his doesn't clog, because then we're just sterilizing this yellow water.
I have 6 gallons of water in my truck.
We'll survive. We're going out tomorrow night anyway. No bicycles.
It's gotta be the lake area.
Sunday afternoon, 1:13. A lot of walking today. We didn't find that big herd this morning, but we saw them going yesterday. We did see one elk by itself kind of in that area in the trees, and heard another kind of crash. And what's that?
And a mule deer.
Yeah, then we just kind of went for a nature hike. Followed an eastern ridge line back to the south here. Met up with the Alpine Trail where we can got a cool view. I don't know if that's this morning at another spot. Got up here just as it was starting to get light where we could walk in without the headlamps on. Got set up on this wallow. Where Kyle missed that one on Wednesday. It's smoky up here today. Got a crazy red sunrise, which that's quite a bit above the horizon and it's still that color. Well, Kyle's heading back to go do some laundry today, and he's going to go sit by himself tonight on something easy from the road. I'm heading down for a couple nights in this ravine. A little smoky. We'll see. Guess I'll do a little video here while I got the jet boil on, covering up my voice. Got into the second spot tonight. I'm pretty excited about it. It's kind of a smaller mountain in the middle of the valley here, and on the west end of it there's a bench with a series of ponds. I think it's called Rubidega Marsh or something. Definitely getting a lot of moo cow use. There's also elk sign in here, some rubs, some fresh droppings that were elk. So I like it. I was getting water at the spring over there, and I did hear a bugle down below. So we got here looking downhill. That's just kind of grass. It's an empty marsh, maybe a little bit of water in it. Probably can't see, but about 40 yards down there, I'm sitting above it pretty good. It's a good water hole. And then you can't see again, but on the other side of those two little cedar trees, that dead one, you can probably just see the top of it, but that's water too. So you got this I'm hoping that they can come in from either one. I'm hoping my thermals will blow down tonight. And if they side hill it, come from that way or that way, I can shoot either water source. I doubt it works that well, but we're gonna find out, so.
Well, I didn't have my camera on for that last bugle a while ago. After I bugled, probably 20 seconds later, he bugled. And he sounded close. I haven't heard enough of these to know what how close is, but you know, 200 yards or less. So I assumed he was coming. I didn't cut him off with the bugle, but I don't know, 30 seconds to a minute, I did another bugle, and he didn't respond to that. Then it had been probably 5 to 10 minutes, and I hadn't heard anything. And I think I did just a bedding bugle. A couple minutes after that, he just bugled again, but he's further. So I don't know. I don't really feel like chasing him. If that's what I should do or not, but I'm just going to wait. It's a water hole. Maybe he's thirsty. I've got tomorrow to chase bugles. I'll keep doing that. I heard a podcast say to keep doing that and just irritate them, so I'm on the water. I imagine they want to be on the water. They can come move me off if they want to. It's real hard not to go running after them, though. I think today is going to be conservative. Should have brought a turkey tag. Got a gobbler down there. He's not in range, but he might be coming. All right, back in the tent. I like this spot. I like it a lot. I saw, heard an elk bugle, maybe a couple. It was either the same elk a couple of different times, or a couple of different elk. One time it was actually pretty close, and I think I messed up. I should have not responded to it. It may have been coming to that water anyway, but it seemed like it got further after that. Turkey came in, 5 or 6 Herefords. They seemed well-mannered. Didn't seem too interested in messing with me if I left them alone, so that made me happy. No bull, which was good to see, or not see, so still something about this place is a little bit creepy. I know there's quite a few bears in the area. The cows, I think the biggest deal is the cows. You just, every time you hear something walking, kind of wondering. It's kind of the same with this tent at night. It's going to be a creepy sleep. I did see a turkey, that's right. I saw a gobbler, could have maybe got off a shot at it, but. Anyway, heard that one bugle from the pond, then I got up after the cows moved in and maybe 10 minutes left of shooting light, and I wanted to get back to this ridge camp and see a little bit more and listen some different directions. Heard a couple of bugles in a couple of different directions, so, and I saw a cow up on the high point. We're down in the saddle here, but oh, tomorrow's going to be interesting. I think it's supposed to just get colder and colder.
As the morning goes on and around noon starts a chance of precipitation. By 2 p.m. it's a real good chance and I think it's going to rain. I'm hoping it's cold enough to be snow. Tomorrow night may be snow. So tomorrow let's go round up some elk. It's going to be fun. Alright, sitting up here to overlook this morning. Just got a bugle. Sounds like down from the ponds I sat on last night. I'm probably just going to sit here and see if it pops up and heads this way. I've got a lot of open ground to cover. I don't know what else I would do at this point. We'll see. Good view of that saddle I'm camped in. Big knob back behind me. And a valley there. This bench, the saddle comes up between those, that next knob and my tents. Oh, thought I heard bugle, but I don't think so. It goes back down that way, so. I don't know what that one did this morning. I ran down there after I heard the bugle sound like he was right on those ponds. Got close, wind was perfect and heavy. He couldn't have heard me or smelled me. Didn't hear anything, so I crept in. And then nothing, he was just gone. So I went and sat at the pond where I sat up last night, gave a few cow calls, nothing. Bugle, nothing. Waited a while. Decided while I was down at the water to go fill up my, refill my water containers, so walk down a couple shelves where it comes out of the ground and it's filtered. I can no longer see the top pond. While I'm filling water, I hear a bugle, kind of a small bugle, quiet, but like he was right up where I was just sitting, it seemed like. So I dropped my water, grabbed my bow, and ran up there. And again, nothing. Don't know where he went, don't know what happened. Then I heard some bugling down below, so I'm thinking maybe that was him. So I came back up here just to do what I intended to do, get a feel for the whole valley, if anything else was making noise. But so far, everything's down there. Of course, I got some worked up bugles on the other hill, so I guess I'm dropping down, seeing what they do. So I'm going to climb to get above them. I think I got a decent marker about where I think they are. Come down from above and see what they're doing. They're still bugling. I thought that was gonna happen. That was fun chasing that herd, but after they spooked, I didn't wanna push them too hard, so I just gained elevation and I'm kinda up here above. I think this may be where they're heading, but I wasn't gonna bird dog them, so. Man, cold front just now hit. I think it's about 10 o'clock. Getting some real light, little heavy snow, mist, I don't know what you'd call it, precipitation. But this temperature keeps dropping. I might be sitting in the snow here in a little bit, so I stopped for a coffee, do a little calling before I enter this big bench that looks like it ought to hold some elk in it, so I'm going to try to call from the perimeter first. Brr. Watching him attack that tree, 45 yards from the tree. I just couldn't get a good view of his body. I was standing around up there. I only tried to move when he was really going, so I don't think he heard me move. I think that wind shifted down and he was, the second he caught it, he was out. So I gave a last ditch effort, maybe it was noise, and tried to bugle at him and run. I don't know what that did. It didn't work. Wind. That guy actually came in hot. Well, I found some dry pine needles under a couple of these pines, but I couldn't get them started until I found some sap. A little bit of sap got me going. Well, you're not going to be able to see that. I think it's supposed to get down as low as mid-20s tonight. So, we're drying things out here. Didn't even burn my pants. That felt good. I was getting pretty cold and the lower legs were wet. Pretty dry now. smart, I'd go sit in the teepee listening for bugles and not come out until there was something to chase. But of course I get dry and here comes some more rain. But at least I'm warm. You don't get this very often, 2 days in a row of snowing. In the elk woods. It's wet snow and the ground's warm enough it doesn't stick, but when it's going, it's sure pretty. Seen a lot of elk sign in here, but it's been a while since I've seen anything. I was following one herd up that had a real excited bull and tried to get crafty with him and sneak around, and by the time I got around to come in from another direction, he was gone. I think they went up this way, but if not, there's a bunch of bedding up this way I want to look at. Work this ridge line today. Back to the truck tonight. Pretty sure I saw her fall, but here's some blood. See her up there. Nice. You can hit the little guys. Actually, I was a little far forward and right on that one too, but oh, this is going to be a much easier pack out. Let's get some pictures. These close, so I'm not gonna wait on Kyle. But I'll film it. Let's see if we can do the gutless method. Okay, so you got the rear quarter off, front shoulder off, just about to get the back strap here. There's that front quarter, that's a good back strap. Probably trim some neck meat while I got it on this side. Flipped over, I'm going to get this hind quarter off. I'll do the legs first, actually. Quarter. Now the trick is, this is guts right here, so just cut in here, in the crease. A little blood ain't gonna hurt anything, but you don't wanna nick the guts. Then there's this ball joint right here. Gotta find it. There it is. Now, just cut away from this pelvic bone. Staying close to the bone. Everything you can get with it, do. there's a hind quarter with some trees. All right, got the backstraps, tenderloins, loose meat, and one hind quarter. Got the other hind quarter and two shoulders left to go. By myself, I think if I hurry, I can get back here before dark, maybe. So I'm not hanging them very high. Ain't gonna stop a bear. Make it tough on a little critter, but I gotta run. I'm not gonna tell Kyle how bad this sucks. I think he's coming in to help me with the last load. Everything is wet and muddy. It's just a slip and slide. Makes it five times harder. Not to mention it's not exactly light. Glad it's a calf, to be honest. Oh, not really. I wish it was that bull. Back to the truck. Kyle had to pack out both packs the last 50 feet because my legs would not even move. Oh, heading back to town.
Whiskey.
And whiskey. Let's do whiskey now. Fingers couldn't work before, but it's time to open the whiskey.
Let's see. It should be the baby elk.
The yearling elk.
Thank God it wasn't a big elk. Get her, growth.
Good.
I didn't know what to do on the beat. It's all just kind of stacked up in there. I didn't know if you needed.